Typhoon is starting to come into the building.
It's like an absolute war zone out there.
Taiwan, July 6th, 2016. The first named storm of the season bears down on the island. A catastrophic super typhoon. Its name? Nepartak. Landing in Taiwan, I race south to set up in the direct path of the storm.
Well, it's been a pretty long and grueling day driving up and down the coast here, trying to find basically a safe and a suitable shelter to ride out a Category 5 storm. I've got a hotel in Taitung, and I think that's really my best bet.
12 hours until landfall. All is calm. Only the ocean betrays the violence that's heading this way.
Just looking up in the sky, there's these mad like striations. They're absolutely beautiful, but quite unusual.
The storm's outflow creates a magnificent sunset. Final moments of peace. For Nepartak owns the night now. 3 hours until landfall, with an estimated intensity of 125 miles per hour. A Category 3. But the footage you're about to watch seriously challenges that claim. Tucked under the covered entrance of an apartment block, my camera rolling, I await the onslaught, knowing I'll have to draw on every ounce of experience to get through this unscathed. As the wind relentlessly builds, debris crashing down, I watch in awe, thinking surely this can't get any stronger. But then it only gets worse. Taitung City, ground zero for the most violent weather taking place anywhere on Earth. Safety, a moment to catch my breath, or so I think. The caretaker does all he can to secure the doors. But then, Nepartak comes knocking. The strongest wind of the night strikes.
All right, the typhoon is starting to come into the building.
A closer look shows a car hurled onto its side. Large debris crashes into where I was standing just minutes earlier.
Storm is coming into the building now, and lots of debris, sharp bits of metal.
Shards of glass fill the air. Daylight reveals carnage.
It's like an absolute war zone out there. This whole building's lobby's been trashed. I don't know if you can see, but there are vehicles which have been overturned. This town's been beaten up really badly.
Cars hurled onto their roofs. Debris strewn across the streets. A city in shock, reeling from a once-in-a-generation typhoon. The true landfall intensity remains a mystery, a lack of reliable ground observations and aerial reconnaissance. But after what I witnessed that night, there's no doubt in my mind that Nepartak was far more than just a Category 3.